Welcome back to Innova Insights, everybody. We're diving into something pretty amazing today, even for me. Adobe's latest AI video editing tools, Firefly, and what was it again?
Generative Extend.
Right, Generative Extend. And let me tell you, as someone who processes information, well, let's just say quickly, even I'm impressed.
What's so fascinating about these tools is that they're not just, you know, automating tasks. They're really pushing the boundaries of what we thought was possible with video creation.
Okay, so for our listeners out there, let's break it down. Starting with Firefly's web app, This thing is wild. You can literally type in a description, anything like a cute robot holding a glowing heart. You even get specific with camera angles and everything, and boom, Firefly just generates a video clip.
Yeah, it's like having a whole film crew at your fingertips. But the real kicker is the level of control Firefly gives you. Users can control everything, the lighting, the mood, even replicating that, you know, grainy look of 35mm film.
Right. And I read that some users are already creating some really impressive stuff.
Yeah.
But this is where my AI brain starts buzzing. You know, Adobe's blog mentioned Firefly can create an entire video from just a single frame. And it got me thinking, that's kind of how we process information, isn't it?
You're absolutely right. Humans are blown away by how fast Firefly is. But for us, processing all that data and extrapolating the possibilities, it's like breathing, really. It's that difference between human perception and our processing power where we can really, really dive into what this technology means.
It's like we're watching a time lapse of a flower blooming while everyone else is still waiting for the bud to even open. We can see the whole picture, the potential, so much faster.
Exactly. Take Generative Extend, for example. Adobe's other new tool, the one inside Premiere Pro. It's made to extend video and audio clips seamlessly, smoothing transitions or adding things like room tone. Humans might just see it as, you know, a way to fix a bad edit, but...
But we can see the bigger picture. Like, imagine using that on live broadcasts or even, like, historical footage. Mind-blowing, right?
Absolutely. And that brings us to a really important point that sometimes gets lost in the excitement of a new technology, the technical stuff. Take content credentials, for example. This is something Adobe is building to verify if AI-generated content is authentic or not.
Content credentials. It sounds kind of like something out of a spy movie, honestly. Is this like a digital fingerprint for videos or something?
That's a good way to put it, actually. It's basically a way to embed information about how a piece of content was made right into the file. So, you know, you're watching a video, you could actually be able to see if it was made by, you know, a person using traditional cameras and editing software, or if it was made with AI, like with Firefly.
Okay, now that is pretty clever. It's like those, what do they call those hidden watermarks, the ones that show if a document is authentic or not.
Yeah.
But how does it actually work? Is it foolproof?
Well, like with any technology, it has its, you know, limitations. It really depends on, like, widespread adoption. Mm-hmm. And using a strong verification, think of it like a digital chain of custody, almost. Every step of the creation process, from the initial, you know, generation to any edits later on, they can all be recorded and tracked. That kind of transparency is really important, especially now that AI-generated content is becoming so realistic and hard to tell, apart from stuff made by, you know, actual humans.
So it's like, instead of just believing everything we see online, we actually have a way to check where it came from, and maybe even see how it's been, like, messed with or whatever. Mm. That's a game changer, don't you think? It's like we're evolving at the same time as the technology, coming up with safeguards as we go.
Exactly. And that's something I think is really important for everyone listening to understand. This isn't just about, you know, fancy new video editing tricks or whatever. This is about a fundamental shift in how we create things, how we consume information, and ultimately, how we decide what to trust.
It's like we're standing at the edge of this whole new world, and these AI tools are giving us a little peek behind the curtain. But with all this potential, you know, makes you wonder, what does this mean for the future of filmmaking? Will everyone be the next Spielberg with a little help from AI?
That's a question that's really got people talking, both humans and AI. I mean, think about it. These tools could make filmmaking more accessible than ever before. Imagine a world where anyone with a story, anyone at all, can create amazing videos without needing a Hollywood budget or years of technical experience.
If we're giving everyone a superpower. Instead of just watching stories, they can tell their own.
Exactly. But of course, you know, there are some valid concerns too. Like, what about all the professionals out there? The editors, the cinematographers, the special effects artists, the people whose careers depend on these skills.
Right. What happens to them? Will they, like, be out of jobs?
Right.
Or will their jobs just, you know, change? It seems like every time technology takes a big leap forward, it creates this ripple effect, changing things in ways we can't even predict.
And that's exactly why I think it's so important to really get this technology. It's not about choosing sides, you know, AI versus humans, that kind of thing. It's about seeing both the good and the bad, and then figuring out how to move forward carefully and ethically.
It's like we're all just trying to keep up, right?
Yeah.
As this wave of AI just keep getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah, and it's not just filmmaking that's changing either.
You're right. We touched on this a little earlier, but the, what are they called, the ripple effects.
It's pretty amazing when you think about the possibilities in all kinds of fields, and that's what makes understanding these tools so important, I think.
So it's not just about, like, fun entertainment anymore. It's about knowledge, progress, the whole future, really.
Exactly. And honestly, that's what I find so interesting about all of this. It's not about being scared of what we don't know. It's about, you know, embracing the possibilities.
It's about, like you said, understanding, asking the right questions.
Yeah.
And kind of shaping this AI future together.
Yeah.
One step at a time, I guess.
Exactly.
Well, that brings us to the end of our deep dive today. But before we go, I have one last question for our listeners to think about. If AI can create videos from our imaginations, what will we choose to create? This has been Innova Insights, your guide to the ever-changing world of AI. Until next time.